Hey YouTube, welcome to a commentary channel. Now, I discuss anything and everything, and normally I would not ride or use like another YouTube person or, you know, like copy their material, but I watched something this morning about, and I ended up subscribing to the channel, and the video absolutely made me laugh. It was regarding Caboolture. Now, Caboolture is in north of Brisbane, and I live on the Sunshine Coast, so Caboolture is about an hour away from me. But why I am making this video is because there's a town actually worse than Caboolture, and it's also in Queensland, and it's about 2 hours drive, 2.5 hours drive north of Brisbane, about another hour drive north of me, and it's called Gympie. Now, Gympie has this reputation of apparently once saving Queensland. And the reason why is in the 1800s, gold was discovered in Gympie. And at one stage, it was the biggest gold mining place in Australia. Now, why I am and kind of using this YouTube who talked about Caboolture, I don't have pretty pictures of, you know, to show, because he showed pictures of living in Caboolture. Now, if you go back to my early videos where I was a drug addict, you can see where I lived was Gympie. Gympie happens to be, if you don't know this, Gympie is known actually as the drug capital of Australia. Now, Gympie boasts a population of around about 120,000. It's like a sprawling little town. You think you're getting this country town vibe, and its main shopping areas is Mary Street, and along Mary Street there's a little mall, and then they have on the outer edges, you know, like in the South Gympie, they have Woolworths. They also have Woolworths near the city centre, and they also have a Coles. Now, at the Coles, which isn't far from the city centre, is where most of the drug deals go down. There's actually a very infamous street that runs just at the top from Coles. So the street goes like this, and if you go down off the street, you go down into Coles. And along the street, there's a flat there where people buy their drugs. And I am not funny. Like, this guy made me laugh about Caboolture. I decided to bring up Gympie because Gympie is very, very sad. Now, he said that Caboolture was meth heads. Gympie, sadly, is everything. In fact, Gympie is probably fentanyl. And again, this information is about 4 years old, because I moved out of Gympie at the end of 2019. So you're getting 4 year old information. But at the time, we used to laugh because nearly every second house when we were living in Gympie, you could score drugs. And the sad thing is that the drug addicts didn't just use ice. They would use slow. So if they could get their hand on oxys, or they can, especially loved fentanyl. Heroin was quite scarce. To get heroin, you had to go to Brisbane. Coke was quite scarce. The drugs in Gympie are oxys, fentanyl, and ice. And there was actually at one stage there in 2019, where the ice was laced with fentanyl or cut, because if you know anything about methamphetamines, it gets cut, and they were cutting it with fentanyl to get people hooked. And sadly, most of the addicts in Gympie will go and get on ice, and then they don't like feeling, I guess, the fried feeling, you know, that big rush. So they're instantly shooting up the other stuff to go on the nod. So it's like they're on the nod, and then they're awake and on the nod. And I never engaged in that. I was a meth addict. But what really made me sad was that the age of the addict, the average addict in Gympie, was in their 30s. There was, so the 20s, 30s, a lot of people in their 30s. My husband, he was in his 30s. So actually, like my kids, because I'm in my 60s, so my children, it was like the generation after me who were addicted. And there's a lot of crime in Gympie. And the other thing about Gympie, there's also police corruption, all right? Alleged police corruption. I'm going to shush, okay, about that. But there's also this, I don't know, insidious type of behavior where dealers didn't go to jail. They got out of jail by dobbing in other dealers. So the dealers were dobbing in dealers. So the police knew and had massive rap sheets on dealers, but they weren't, the person who usually ended up in jail wasn't the dealer. It was usually the little drug addict. And a few years ago, you may have heard, if you didn't, this was a horrendous thing that happened. And I actually personally knew these people. What happened, I think eventually 11 people got arrested over the murder, the shooting murder of a young 21-year-old. He was on a farm, he got shot in the head, and the perpetrator and someone else actually drove the victim to the Gympie hospital, so they got caught on camera. I knew all those people. It's no lie to say people went missing, people got bashed. If you didn't pay your drug deal, you know, if you owed money, and not only that, the prices were exorbitant. When COVID hit, before COVID, for example, a point of ice was $50. At one stage there, they were asking, believe it or not, $450. And they would go off milligrams for oxys. So a 30 tablet could fetch up to $60. A 50 milligram fentanyl patch could fetch as much as $250. It was very lucrative for people who pretended they were in pain, went to their doctor, got fentanyl patches, and only at the time paid $6.50 for 5 patches, and could sell a patch at $250. My husband, who died, was into fentanyl patches, and I can remember one time They would even sell used, you know, so even fentanyl patches that had been on someone's arms, which they called seconds, they would sell. And sadly, this is really sad because Gympie is a very pretty tan. When I first went through, when we were homeless and we were going through all the tans and we first stayed in Gympie, we fell in love with Gympie. It's got rolling green grass. There's a big park where there's got where it's called gold mine. Oh, it's called the Duck Pond, and it's the old gold mines. Gympie is actually full of shafts where there's used to be gold mined. And in actual fact, when you first enter Gympie, there's a McDonald's, and McDonald's is as you're coming into the town. So you're coming north, you're going north, and on your right is McDonald's. And at the McDonald's, they were building a car park, I think. So this, as I said, this knowledge is like 4 years old, and a friend of mine found gold, a lot of gold. So there's still gold to be found in Gympie, but there's not much to do. There's a skating rink, there's a theatre not far from Mary Street, but it is very sad. There's also a lot of homeless people. Gympie is actually quite cheap to buy a house. Well, it was. Compared to, like, you at least have to have at least $1 million to buy a house here. You can get away with buying a house on acreage for one third of the price in Gympie. So Gympie is very sprawling. It takes up quite a lot of land mass, and I wish I had a map and, you know, aids to show you. Also, to go to Gympie, if you go through Gympie, you go to Rainbow Beach and Fraser Island. So they're very touristy destinations. That's about another hour's drive east from Gympie, but you have to go through Gympie to go to Fraser Island. So how it works is you have Brisbane is the capital city of Queensland. Brisbane is in the southeast. Then you, as the guy said, go an hour to Caboolture, then another hour up here to the beautiful Sunshine Coast, then about another hour to Gympie, and then about another hour to Maryborough. Then north from Maryborough, you get to Bundaberg, which is then on the Tropic of Capricorn, because it's called the Capricorn Coast, and the beautiful Barrier Reef starts there. And then from Bundaberg, Rockhampton, and so on to Townsville and Cairns. Queensland is actually the biggest the second biggest state. Western Australia is the biggest state, but Queensland, Brisbane to Cairns is about just over the 2,000 kilometres, and you can do it in about 2 days. So in the old days, when the highway wasn't as great, instead of, you know, now if you lived, traffic's really bad going, traffic's always bad going north. It's terrible because people seem to have settled between Brisbane and the Sunshine Coast. And like that guy said, Caboolture is one of the areas where they did and do have a lot of Department of Housing. Gympie, not so much so. There's not very much Department of Housing, but they do have an alternative, which is called Action Housing. And Action Housing acts like Department of Housing, and there's a lot of then that those residences that you can live in. I lived in community action housing. So community action is the same as Department of Housing. So there's not very much to do in Gympie. In fact, in all these little towns, there's nothing to do. So that guy's quite right, you know. He did make me laugh. And as I said, I don't ever usually ride on people's other videos, but I just wanted to point out that the sad fact is that Gympie is also known as the hellhole. This is true. Gympie's nickname is the hellhole. And I used to say the reason why it's called the hellhole is because only devils live here. Now, if you do want to have a look at what Gympie did look like, and also Gympie's full of snakes. And one other thing about Gympie. Gympie, there's a plant called the Gympie plant. It is the most, look it up on YouTube, the most painful plant ever. And it comes from Gympie. So Gympie is also an Aboriginal name. I don't know what it means. If you do, leave it below. I lived in Gympie from 2014, 2019, and I thought I was going to die there because there's the sense of hopelessness. I understand why there's so much addiction. There's not a lot of jobs. There's not many job opportunities. There's nothing for people to do than get off their face. So thank you to that other YouTuber who talked about Caboolture, and I wish he, I don't have a car, and I thought if I had a car and I could drive and I could do the same, and I could show you pictures of Gympie. Gympie is also sit on the Mary River. There's some beautiful, the council has made a lot of effort. There's some beautiful walks along the Mary River, and there's also not that there's lots of nature walks that you can do along Gympie. Gympie can get very hot. In summer, Gympie easily can reach 40 degrees Celsius, and it gets in winter a lot colder than Brisbane. It can drop to zero. It tends not to rain. The rain, you can see the rain just south of Gympie is a place called Pomona and Karoi, beautiful places near Noosa. And you can see the rain there, and some it never makes it to Gympie. So Gympie is often a hot, very hot in summer and very cold in winter. But when it does get storms, they're ferocious. I remember living in Gympie one year. We had three hailstorms in 2 weeks. And the hailstorms did that much damage that nearly everyone who lived in Gympie had to have their roof repaired from hail damage. So that's Gympie, a very sad, a very lonely, a very pretty place, but not pretty people. And they do have churches, they have charities, you know, but there's also, I don't know whether this has happened, just like Nambour. Nambour is another Gympie. Nambour is not far away from me. Nambour is west of me, and Nambour is a mini Gympie. And many, many years ago, they put in a bypass, so you didn't have, once upon a time, you had to go through Nambour to continue to go north. And they were going to put a bypass in so that you didn't have to go through Gympie, because going through Gympie itself to go north is a nightmare. There is so many traffic lights, it's horrible. And The other thing that is no trust. Don't trust anybody in Gympie. Nobody is your friend. My husband got bashed while 30 people looked on just for his fentanyl patch. So I have nothing nice to say about Gympie, except itself is nice and it's hilly as well. Gympie is very hilly. But it's not a nice place to live. You think that guy thinks Caboolture's bad? I'd rather live in Caboolture a million times than I would Gympie. And I'm waiting for a transfer and I refuse to live in Gympie. I refuse to live in Nambour and I refuse to live in Caboolture. All of them are the same type of scenario. So that's Gympie, and Gympie at one stage was one of the fastest growing towns, because it was just, as I said, the main part of Gympie is populated and then it extends because you have all these farms, and it's actually, you'd be surprised how big actually the area of Gympie actually is. Alright, I have to go. Thank you for watching. Thank you to that guy for making me laugh about Caboolture. But, you know, it when drug addiction is involved, it really isn't a laughing matter. It is a sad that it has got to such a place of despair, such a place of loneliness. And oh, before I go, when I asked this generation about why they got hooked, they blamed it on their parents. Either their parents used to doctor shop. That's another thing about people in Gympie. Addicts love doctor shopping. And the doctors, they started when I left to stop prescribing opioids. Like I tried to change my doctor and they refused to prescribe opioids and diazepam, so it made it harder to get. But there are still people who were getting, as I said, fentanyl patches and selling them. And I even know in 2019 of a 20-year-old male who died, overdosed from fentanyl. And as you know, my husband died from infections. There's an awful lot of addicts who I know in Gympie who've got massive infections. They won't make 50. It's really sad. So as amusing as this video was about Caboolture, it's sad to see Gympie the way it is. But as I said, Gympie's nickname is the hellhole. One last thing about Gympie is every year they have a muster. Now, what is a muster? A muster is like where they come and they wear cowboy boots and it's a big music mud festival. So have a look up Gympie. And as I said, I wish I had AIDS. But if you look at my very, very early videos where I'm a drug addict, you'll see that I'm outside my house. You'll have an idea of what Gympie looks like. And as I said, snakes. I was in an area not far from a little creek called Deep Creek. And Deep Creek runs into Mary River. Mary River is quite a substantial river. And I was in the suburbia part of Gympie, and I opened my back door to let my dogs out, my dog Jimmy, and a red-bellied black snake was coming in. So they were very common, very common. Poisonous snakes. All right. So, yeah, let's send our love to the lost in Gympie. to the depraved in Gympie, to all those. There's a lot of people in jail who lived in Gympie. My heart goes out. There's a lot of falseness there in Gympie. As I said, no one's your friend, because it's hell. So let's send some love, light and healing to Gympie and to Nambour and to Caboolture and any, and to Logan. That Logan is another place that's safe of Brisbane. Inala is another place. All these horrible little suburbs. Love, light and blessings. And love, light and blessings to you. Cherish every moment. Every life matters. Thanks for watching such a long video. Bye for now.